This is actually the UK premiere of this product, the Orion. This is one down from our flagship product, which is called the Lyra. So these retail for £140,000. They're pretty much the best thing that we can make. They weigh 150 kilos. And I'll tell you a little bit about the construction, the technology behind it, and mostly we'll listen to music. First, I'll tell you, are you guys familiar with Rockport Technologies? Have you ever heard of the company before? Yeah? Okay. So it was started in 1990 by Andy Payer, who's an electrical engineer by education. He was recently inducted into the High-End Audio Hall of Fame. He's quite well known within the loudspeaker world. But one of the things that he pioneered was using composites in loudspeaker design, both in the cabinets and also in the driver construction. So the first speaker that Andy designed was called the Procyon, and that was launched in 1993, so exactly just about 30 years ago. I'm telling you about the Procyon because really it's a precursor to the technology that we're using in the Orion. So the Procyon was a dual shell composite cabinet. So what that means is it had a fiberglass outer shell and a fiberglass inner shell, and it had a damping core that bonded the two shells together. And the reason why composite construction is important is because you need three things to build a quiet loudspeaker. You need mass, you need damping, and you need stiffness. But monolithic materials don't have all three things. If you look at aluminum, for example, aluminum is stiff. It has the potential to be massive, but it rings. And actually, the stiffer it is, the more it rings. So in order to get a really quiet cabinet, you have to use composites. And Rockport's been using composites since its first loudspeaker. The Orion is an evolution of that design, except instead of fiberglass on the inside and fiberglass on the outside, we're using cast aluminum on the inside. So there's a massive cast aluminum structure on the inside. And then on the outside, there's a carbon fiber shell. And between them is our proprietary viscoelastic damping core. Viscoelastic just means it's got viscous and elastic properties. So basically it stays a bit squishy. It doesn't really ever harden. And what you want is if there's energy on the outside of the speaker or the inside of the speaker, it essentially, it gets absorbed by that damping material. And it's also giving you a lot of mass because in the case of this speaker, there's 50 kilograms of our damping material in this speaker, okay? That's a little bit about the Orion cabinet technology. I'm gonna play the first piece of music and then I'll tell you some more about the kind of design goals behind Orion. Sound good? All right. The first track I'm gonna play you is the Ray Brown Trio. It's a live recording in a very small venue. So this is a jazz club in Boston. It's about 2 hours from where I live, although I've never been there and I really want to go there. It only seats about 175 people. It's all table seating. So hopefully if we've done a good job of making a quiet loudspeaker, you'll get a sense of what it's like to sit at Sculler's and kind of be in the audience. So we'll listen to Ray Brown. I'm gonna cut it off there, but did you guys get a little bit of a sense of what it was like to be at Sculler's? There's a real intimacy about it. I love the dynamics on that track because you go from, you know, being immersed with that bass line and then you start, then the crowd comes in and starts clapping out of nowhere and you're like, oh wait, I'm in a club now, you know? But that's, you know, that's really the idea behind all this hi-fi stuff is at the end of the day, even though there's a lot of gear here, we're really trying to make this gear go away. All we want to leave you with is the musical experience. We want you to be able to, you know, have a live concert in your house whenever you want, because that's fun, that's magical. So I'll tell you a little bit about the design parameters for Orion and what we were trying to accomplish here. Really, what we wanted to do is build the smallest, purest expression of a three-way loudspeaker that we could, that could actually fit into normal living spaces. You know, most speakers at this level, super speakers, are quite large. And a lot of them are actually flanked with really large subwoofers. And, you know, they're a thing that you'd put in like a dedicated room that only one person can enjoy at a time kind of a thing. We wanted to make a little speaker that sounded big. And that's the idea behind Orion. One of the design constraints is because we had a small cabinet to work with, we only wanted to use three drivers because we wanted this to be a pure three-way, three-driver loudspeaker. All of the drivers had to get pretty large. And up until this point, we didn't have drivers this big. Our mid-range driver is 6 inches. The tweeters we use on our other speakers are 1 inches. And our flagship speaker above this uses a 2 10-inch drivers. But because we needed more surface area, we had to do all new drivers. So Orion was actually a fairly ambitious project because we had to do a completely new cabinet design, and we had to build 3 new drivers from scratch that delivered the surface area that we wanted. So we started with a tweeter. When we started the R&D process for Orion, nobody made a beryllium dome that was 1.25 inches, which is primarily why we decided to make one ourselves, but we had no choice. And so this is a 1.25 inch waveguide loaded beryllium dome. Below it is our brand new 7-inch carbon fiber sandwich composite cone mid-range driver. And below that is the biggest driver we've ever made, our carbon fiber sandwich composite woofer. So between these three drivers, you have all the surface area you need, but you have a very pure expression. There's nothing that gets lost. This speaker really translates music very well. That's kind of the idea behind Orion. I'll play another track for you, and then I can talk a little bit about the driver design itself without getting too technical. I don't want to bore anybody. Does anybody want technical stuff? See, I was reading the audience well there. So let's listen to another piece of music. This piece of music is Fink. Have you guys heard of Fink? This recording was made in 2011, and it was made at Union Chapel in London. So I thought it'd be fitting to play it for you guys. So we're going from a 175-seat jazz club, Scullers. This is a bit bigger. This venue holds about 900 people can sit in Union Chapel, and it's chapel, so it's a much different, the hall, it's got a much different, I've never been there, but apparently it's an incredible place to go listen to live music, and if I lived here, I would go check it out, so you guys should too. But here's Fink.
Troubles maturing. Trouble. With a dress that's as black as my heart on this train. Troubles maturing. Trouble.
Get a sense of what Union Chapel sounds like, you know? What I love about that track is you get a real sense of that first octave bass response and the quietness of the speaker and why it's so important to have a quiet loudspeaker. Because, you know, at the end of the day, all of this is just for the system to disappear. And that's why we build the cabinet the way we do. That's why we build the drivers the way we do. I won't go into super technical detail about the drivers, but I do want to tell you a little bit about how we do our drivers, because there's very few loudspeaker companies that actually make their own drivers from scratch, and we do. Has anyone seen the checkerboard pattern before on other loudspeakers, by the way? You seen that before? So this pattern, this is called spread toe carbon fiber. Rockport actually was the first company in the audio industry to utilize this fabric in making a loudspeaker cone. That was in 2011 with the Avior 1, so roughly 10 years before anybody else started using it. That doesn't really matter, but the reason why we use it is because it's the stiffest and lightest carbon fiber fabric that you can buy. If anyone wants to know why it's the stiffest and lightest, I can talk to you about it later, but it gets a bit technical. The cool thing to understand, though, is that carbon fiber on its own is not strong in all directions. In other words, carbon fiber, take a piece of carbon fiber fabric, it's bendy. Where it's strong is in its tensile strength. So in other words, it doesn't like to be stretched, okay? The way we exploit that is we do a sandwich cone composite. So we take a substrate. This is honeycomb, but we use foam, we use Roacil. And then we put a layer of, we do a carbon fiber skin on the top and a carbon fiber skin on the bottom. If you take this inner material, it's kind of bendy on its own, but if you put a skin on top and a skin on the bottom, you can't bend this. The reason why you can't bend this is because you're putting this skin in tension. You're utilizing it where it's strong. Right now, you're making it so it wants to stretch. It's the same principle as an I-beam. You know, if you take a piece of steel on top and a piece of steel on the bottom and you separate it by a section thickness, when you try and bend that I-beam, it doesn't want to bend because you're asking the steel to stretch. That's what makes this work. What's cool about this, though, and I can pass around these samples if you want to experience that for yourself. But what's cool about this is it gives us incredible strength, but it's very, very light. Okay, so this cone, this is our 6-inch mid-range driver, this cone weighs about 2 US pennies, okay? But it's so strong, it's so stiff that a full-grown adult could almost stand on this without it deforming, okay? So that's very cool. We take that stiff and light cone and we mount it to a really big motor system. And what we get is an incredibly responsive driver that translates music efficiently with very little frictional loss. So it stops and starts quick and you just get the music. And that's why we take the time to build our own cones, because these are better than you can buy anywhere else. We don't know of any drivers that measure and perform better than the ones that we make. It's the same principle as a race car. You've got a light body and a big engine, and you can corner, and it gives you a responsiveness. It's like a race car for drivers. So, you know, the formula with Rockport loudspeakers is essentially, we take the best drivers that we can make, and we put them in the best cabinets that we can make. And as a customer, what you pay for as you go up the line in Rockport is a better and better cabinet, because we always give you our, oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. We always give you our best driver. So even our smallest speaker, the Atria 2, and its big brother, which is actually on display here, the Avior 2, they have our best driver technology. We don't hold back our driver technology, but as you go up the line, you get kind of crazier and crazier cabinet construction. And the Orion is just about the best that we can do. Lyra is better, but Orion is up there. Okay, so I'll play you another track, and then we can touch on our crossover technology, and I can answer any questions for you guys. This last track I'm going to play for you, I actually got turned on to in August at the Hong Kong Hi-Fi show. My distributor there turned me on to it. This is Abdullah Ibrahim. He's a South African composer and pianist. I don't know if anybody's familiar. I really like this song a lot. It's called Calypso Minor. It's off the album Sotho Blue, which is a 2011 recording. And it's a studio recording. This is the first studio recording we've heard, not live. I love that piece of music. The flutist, the horn, there's a jump factor that a system like this can give you that is really emotive. And I think that track did a good job of illustrating how big this speaker sounds, even though it's not physically big, which is really was the main goal with the speaker. Another little thing to highlight. So the speaker below this in our line is called the Cygnus. The Cygnus is actually physically larger on the outside than this speaker, except for the bass, because Cygnus doesn't have these outriggers. Otherwise, Orion's actually slightly smaller. But it's bigger on the inside. So because we're using this cast aluminum construction, we need less internal bracing. So the cabinet volume is about 15% bigger than Cygnus, even though it's smaller on the outside. And this idea, if you talk to Andy Pear about it, he uses the word potency. He's trying to distill hi-fi, you know? How can we make that kind of big sound, but in a package that could actually live in a normal living environment? And that's really what Orion's all about. I'll touch on one more thing that Rockport does and then answer any questions that you guys have. Talk a little bit about the crossover. First of all, does everybody know what a crossover does in a loudspeaker? Yeah? Anybody not know? Because I'll skip it. Okay. So a crossover is a thing in the speaker that, so the musical signal is coming in and it splits up the signal and says, high frequencies, you go to this driver. Mid-range frequencies, you go to this driver. Low frequencies, you go to this driver. Okay, it's kind of the brains. And really, it's kind of the secret sauce to a loudspeaker. You can do a lot of things right. You can have an awesome cabinet. You can have awesome drivers. If you mess up the crossover, it's all for naught. At the very high end, and we only make really high-end loudspeakers, you have to have a crossover that you can adjust. And I'll tell you why. So most loudspeakers, when you design a loudspeaker system, you set a crossover, you set the values, and then you build it on a PC board. PC boards don't allow you to adjust them after the values are set. So at that point, what you're doing is you're assembling the loudspeaker, you're putting the drivers in the cabinet, and you're soldering wires from the crossover to the drivers, and you're shipping off a speaker to somebody. The problem with that is that even very closely matched drivers differ from each other a little bit for many reasons. One of them is that they use magnets, and magnets are natural, and natural elements vary from each other, you know, slightly. And the places where they vary is actually at their frequency extremes, which is where you're trying to cross them over. So, you know, the tweeter, the low end of the tweeter gets a little weird. The top end of the mid-range driver gets a little weird. Those are the places that are most critical. And what we do is we build our crossover in a way, it's on a breadboard, it's all discrete components, and it's built so that we can adjust it during the build process. So what we do with each pair of speakers, and it's not just for Orion, we do this for every pair of speakers, including our smallest speaker, Atria 2, is we put the drivers in the loudspeaker, we've got the crossover outboard of the loudspeaker, and we take measurements. And then we make adjustments on the crossover that compensate for these micro variations in the drivers. And that allows us to deliver a pair of speakers that sounds the same as the ones that we just shipped every single time, because we take the time to individually calibrate the crossover for the specific drivers that are in the loudspeaker. Part of that process involves measurement. Part of it involves pushing them into our listening room and listening and making small adjustments in the listening room, because some things you can barely see on the measurement, but you can hear very obviously. And so some of that work is done in the listening room, and then it's brought back out to the microphone again. And that process is repeated. It's an iterative process that's repeated until we get it right for every pair of speakers. Each individual pair. And sometimes it can take us 2 to 3 days just to do one pair of speakers. You know, we don't ship a lot of speakers a year, but if you buy a Rockport, we've all listened to the pair that you bought, and it's been worked on for days in the build process. Okay, this is a track, this is the band Lake Street Dive. And they're doing a cover of a Jackson 5 track that I like. It's a fun one. This whole album is covers. If you like this song, check out the whole album. But someone picked you from the bunch. One glance was all it took. Thought that was a fun one. Anyway, that's all I got for you guys. I appreciate you coming and listening to Orion and being part of the UK launch here. And I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your time at the Ascot show.
Thank you.
Thank you guys. Thank you.